Business viewers, urban issues are increasingly prominent on national policy agendas. Cities and metropolitan areas are major contributors to national economies and for sure play a key role as nodes in global markets. Moreover, at a time of deepening globalization and increasing international competition for investment, metropolitan regions have become the targets of a wide range of public interventions. Now, urban development policies seek to address a range of issues, from managing urban expansion and congestion to fostering competitiveness, innovation, social inclusion, and environmental sustainability. This is MNC Business, and you are on Economic Buzz. Urban development issues should be understood not only in recognizable everyday problems such as traffic congestion, slums and crime, but also needs to be viewed within the broader context. Cities play an important role in the national economy, as more than half of the national GDP is generated from the major cities. There are some issues of urban development in which the central as well as local government as well as other stakeholders have to address. We have the report for you.
Urban areas in Indonesia had a typical problem such as urbanization, environmental and social. Various urban problems were arising from the spatial planning of cities that were not clear and also inconsistency of policymakers in implementing development plans. Generally, the executive and legislative are still thinking conventionally and have no development concepts which are firm and clear. It is also observed that many regional heads did not familiar with the concept of urban development which was sustainable or a development that was environmentally insightful. There are two major things to respond to city development problems, planning and constructing. However, the problems could also come from local government's own policy which did deviation on city spatial planning. Local regulations that were published on city spatial planning sometimes could just be a formality concept, because local governments sometimes are not consistent in implementing development plans. Besides, there were also ineffectiveness and incoordination among agencies and institutions. The other problem is the integration between cities and districts, like gap or region issues. The idealist step of a balanced city gave a progress and did not weaken the adjacent regions. To create a comfortable city, structuring the city must be planned carefully. The situation sometimes already had a spatial plan, but the implementation is not in accordance with government regulations. Therefore, there could be violations that have been done and being ignored. For example, mall construction, which is not in accordance with the spatial plan in district or city. Apparently, when people opposed against the construction, but it kept running without any sanction. The other main issue is government lack of ability to anticipate the problems in the future. The Indonesian government is still considered incapable of carrying out a good planning. Sometimes regulation is less able to overcome the problems in the future that its development runs so fast. So violation on spatial plan cannot be avoided. What should be prepared in creating a good idea spatial plan related to urban development issue? MNC Business Report for Economic Buzz and MNC Business Channel.
And to have a deeper view about understanding urban development challenges with New Cities Foundation, or NCF, we have Mathieu Lefevre, Executive Director at New Cities Foundation. Mathieu, bonjour.
Bonjour.
Merci beaucoup for your time.
Thank you very much. Merci beaucoup.
Yes, really appreciate for your time. And this is the first time we have NCF, stands for New Cities Foundation. We should talk about this in more detail later on. In the meantime, they can also visit your homepage. Which homepage should I visit if I would like to know more about NCF?
newcitiesfoundation.org.
Okay, as simple as it sounds, .org. Well, Mathieu, I would like to ask you first your general perspective by the time we talk about the dream of the urban population in terms of having, living, and creating a comfortable city. How would you define actually the word comfortable city?
That's a very interesting question. I think the aspirations of people who live in cities are very important, and they're very common. Mm. What's very interesting is that people in small cities and in big cities across the world, in rich cities and in poorer cities, they really focus on the same kinds of issues. Mm. They want fairly basic things. Housing is always one. Security is very important. Mobility and traffic is a big issue here in your hometown in Jakarta, mm-hmm. but also everywhere. So it's very interesting to think that people, when they think about their life in cities, and as you know and will discuss, more and more people are living in cities, they aspire to the same things.
Mm. How livable, actually, on the global scale, by the time we talk about the urban development, major cities around the world, how livable it can provide the convenience and also the comfort zone for the urban population around the world nowadays? What dramatic changes happening now?
Well, we're living in a very exciting time. That's why I'm very happy to be here in Jakarta to have this conversation on the future of cities, because we think very deeply at the New Cities Foundation that thinking about cities and creating better cities is really the challenge of our time. We think that we live in a century of cities. Mm. By the middle of this century, the urban population of the world will have grown by about 2 billion people. Mm. It's growing at a rate of about 2 people per second. So by the time I finish my sentence, there will be 10 or 12 new urban
Another
people.
Another increase and growth. Yeah.
Exactly,
yeah.
Exactly. So this is the challenge of our times. Cities are where the action is happening. And I think we are not driving this train. This train is unstoppable, the train of urbanization in this century. And if you look around in cities in Asia, and particularly here in Indonesia, it's evident. But there are two directions this train can go in. A very happy direction to create green, livable, equitable, happy cities, or a much less happy direction of traffic congestion and inequality and smog, etc.
When you use the word unstoppable, can we expect somehow to make this kind of flow of the urban population becoming controllable? How controllable can it be by the time you talk about the flowing, the growing and the increasing number of the urban population coming in and keep flowing in the major cities?
Well, I think people have dreams and aspirations, and I think they should be allowed to exercise those dreams and to make those dreams come true. So I am personally not a big believer in controlling population movement. However,
you're not suggesting that at the same time.
Yes, no.
To control this. Yeah.
But what we want to do is to provide this urban dream to make it a reality, so that people get to cities that conform to their dream and aspiration.
Very good, sir. We still have another session to discuss more about this.
Great.
Make sure you are with us on Economic Buzz. We are now discussing about understanding urban development challenges with New Cities Foundation, or NCF. Don't forget to watch our new live streaming through www.sindonews.com.
Stay tuned for more business insights on MNC Business.
Hai, saatnya ketemu langsung dengan bintang-bintang favoritmu dalam konser yang penuh warna. Afgan, Tulus, Kahitna, Indahnya Pertari, Angel Peters, Karina Salim. 13 Maret jam 7 malam di Balai Sarbini. Ayo, buruan beli tiketnya. MNC Channels presents Lively Concert.
Move like the great you people. You're watching Ravnus International on the weekend.
It's all about economic updates from around the world.
Governments get the first smelter development to be done collectively for the development to be more effective.
Ternyata kalau kita lihat floating itu, Nyebon akan susah membangun sendiri.
Do you think it is wise to make such policy?
Yeah, so I'm quite impressed by the internet, so actually just...
Revenues International, only on MNC Business.
Thank you. sebuah dinamika indah antara jiwa yang sehat dengan pancaran aura kecantikan. Menampilkan sebuah kesempurnaan harmoni. Segalanya dimulai dari dalam hingga membentuk kepercayaan diri. Karena penampilan Anda cerminan utama kepribadian. Dan kebugaran Anda menjadi kunci sukses segala aktivitas. Inilah rahasia tentang semua nilai estetika manusia. Harmony is MNC Health and Beauty. Summary and Outlook on MNC Business.
On business and economic update news first for you. Business viewers, Ministry of Transportation asserted some connectivity aspects could be improved by the development of railway outside Java, as in the government's 5 years program on infrastructure. It is expected that the development would create synergy among transportation modes and eventually suppress logistics costs.
Ministry of Transportation will soon start the development of railways outside Java, created as part of government's 5 years program on infrastructure. By improving infrastructure in train transportation, it is believed that it could create synergy among other transportation modes and finally suppress the logistic costs, which is considered to be too high. Director General of Railways in the Ministry of Transportation, Hermanto Dwiatmoko, explained that there will be some developments done in some different areas in the country. For example, there will be 13 airports and 20 seaports in the country with train access.
Dari jumlah bandara yang terakses, nantinya dua bandara menjadi 13 bandara. Sekarang yang terakses Kuala Namu dan Jogja, yang sudah akses langsung. Nanti 13 bandara, termasuk trek-trek baru ini akan bersambung, termasuk di Surabaya, Makassar, dan sebagainya. Kemudian pelabuhan yang diakses kereta api sekarang 5 pelabuhan, nanti menjadi 20 pelabuhan.
Hermanto also added that aside from increasing the number of airports and seaports with train access, government is also planning to increase the number of city having train as its mass transportation. Based on the data, there are 7 of metropolitan cities in the 2014 which have train as mass transportation. Then it is targeted that in 2019, the number will increase by 2 times into 14 cities. Jakarta, Ricky Anwardi, MNC Business.
We'd like to greet you business people in Singapore. You're an economic boss, English talk show program that outlook the economic and social issue for your business plan. We are still discussing about the understanding urban development challenges with New Cities Foundation, or NCF. We have Mathieu Lefevre as the executive director at New Cities Foundation. And as we speak, you can also log on and go visit the page at newcitiesfoundation.org to get further info. I'm so excited in terms of promoting about NCF as well as the detailed info you have there in your homepage, because you choose Jakarta. I mean, NCF choose Jakarta as the venue, as the host for the summit this shortcoming June, if I'm not mistaken.
That's
June,
right,
or
yeah.
July, June 2015. Okay, we should talk about that in later on session. Okay, further to our conversation early on, Jakarta, it is pretty obvious that we are not the only one who suffers the most in terms of creating a livable town, a comfortable zone for the urban population. Anyway, when we try to find the basic general thing, what typical problem commonly faced by the urban areas related to this kind of spatial issue? Is it always about spatial issue all the time?
Well, I think a large part of it is about spatial issue, but it's not just about spatial issue. And I hope we can talk about problems related to finance and governance. But I like to think, I'm an optimist by nature, so I like to think that these challenges that cities face, including Jakarta, are also great opportunities. For example, for your viewers in the business community, I think this represents an unprecedented business opportunity, because to create better solutions to answer people's problems in cities. And people's problems, as I was relating to earlier, are fairly common. traffic, and your report about trains is, and transportation is very important. Traffic, housing, water, insecurity, participation, feeling that you belong, culture, all of these are common issues. They're also opportunities, for example, for the private sector to step in.
Just now we have also a short package talking about interconnectivity and infrastructure. Now, on your idea, Mathieu, the other common problem related to this kind of interconnectivity and infrastructure, we talk about the urban development, is the integration between cities and the districts around the main cities that is not established yet. We talk about this kind of major gap. On your own experience in NCF and going around the world, what it takes to bridge this kind of gap by the time you would like to build a good cities and the, what do you call this, around sub-district will be benefited also.
Right, yeah. Well, if you look at a picture of urbanization today, really more than cities, we're talking about urban corridors.
Urban corridors.
Yeah. And so if you think about the case of Shanghai, it's not really Shanghai anymore. It's this massive urban region which has tens of millions of people called the Pearl River Delta, which is really the unit to think about it. And I think Java, for example, has the opportunity in the next 10, 20 years to become a very productive world-leading urban corridor where all of the different urban centers are linked. This will also, I think, help release some of the pressure that's felt in Jakarta right now. And all of this really talks about the issue of governance, and that's a critically important issue, how these urban corridors are governed, because you know, your viewers are in the business sector and they will know the importance to have a strong business sector. I think there's a very important element is to have a strong public sector that can direct and sort of accompany progress and development.
Do you see that in our current new government? If I may ask you this, I'm so tickled in terms of asking you this, the strong, what do you call this, a political will as well as the support in terms of creating those?
I'm really not an authority. I don't know.
But at least from the policy they made, the regulation they made here, on the regulatory aspect or framework, how do you see? No, I would like to bring Indonesia in our discussion.
Sure. Well, I'm really not an authority on Indonesia, so I'm not credible to judge. But what I can detect is that there is a momentum. There is a moment, which is also why we picked seizing the urban moment as the topic for our summit. There is a great sense of opportunity here around the question of urban areas. And of course, government is never a stranger to creating that moment of opportunity. So I think there's something happening here, and it's very interesting. And increasingly in Europe, in North America, and elsewhere in Asia, Jakarta and Indonesia are catching the attention of people. They're intrigued by what's happening here.
What is so unique when we talk about the characteristic of Jakarta as the major city, especially as the capital city of a nation, on your view?
Well,
I think
certainly Jakarta is not without its challenges, but I think there's a tremendous enthusiasm here that you can feel. People are, at the very basic level, very hopeful about the future. The business community is very hopeful. The investment community is very hopeful. That, in today's world, if you look outside of Indonesia, is fairly rare, that optimism. That's also why we were very excited to pick Jakarta as the destination for our next big event here in Jakarta in June.
Yeah, Mathieu, now it's becoming the current trending trend. Every single media also making the headline when we talk about go green, green, environment-friendly business, and so forth. Now, the uncontrolled rapid urban development could affect not only, as we know, social problems, but also the environment. How challenging is it on the view of NCF by the time we talk about creating a green city concept? How green can we be regarding our city concept?
Well, again, I'm an optimist, so and a realist as well. The environmental problems that we face are global, and even though it's heads of nations who go discuss environmental problems in big summits, in my hometown in Paris, we will have the climate negotiations in December. I strongly believe that it's cities who will do. They will not talk; they will do. It's in cities that you can actually create these green cities. Most CO2 emissions, greenhouse gas emissions, come from cities indirectly. So it's in cities that we will have to solve the problem. So creating green cities is not really a luxury or a fantasy. It's an obligation. We have to.
So we must make it as a mandatory step to
get
by every one of us here as the part of the nation. Well, we are going to talk in more detail about what is actually this summit and why is it so important, especially given the context of Indonesia. After this one, Mathieu. on the discussion about understanding urban development challenges with New Cities Foundation, or NCF, will be brought to you soon. Stay with us on Economic Bus. This is MNC Business Channel and StarHub Asia Channel, Singapore.
Stay tuned for more business insights on MNC Business.
Pemberitaan menjadi pilihan utama pemirsa saat ini. Di tahun ke-9 ini, MNC News terus setia hadir menjadi channel berita 24 jam dalam memberikan informasi yang berkualitas, yang tercepat dan akurat. Dirgahayu ke-9 MNC News terus maju menjadi yang terdepan di pemberitaan negeri. MNC News, the most comprehensive and informative news channel.
Always bring you more knowledge for your business and economic updates. Summary and Outlook will help you to give most accurate prediction in business world for 1 week ahead.
Yang membuat akhirnya kepercayaan diri para investor baik itu lokal maupun asing.
With more insight and suggestion by our expert, Summary and Outlook on MNC Business.
These policymakers, market analysts, market players, and many inspiring business experts will reveal the secrets for their great business achievements. Get the finance strategy for your business plan.
Kenaikan suku bunga acuan yang mendapatkan respon positif dari pasar saham domestik.
Only on Movers and Shakers on MNC Business.
News International, only on MNC Business.
We have corporate news for you. Business viewers, MNC Group, that is currently working on the development of Ciawi Sukabumi Highway, stated that when the highway is operating, it will help on making logistic costs in West Java area much lower. This will also attract more investment and business expansion.
The development of Ciawi Sukabumi Highway, currently under process, was believed to bring a very positive contribution on the business and economic activity. This will help on making the goods distribution easier, as well as making the logistics costs lesser. Director of PT MNC Tol Investama, Syafril Nasution, pointed out that minimum number of highway in Indonesia and also road network in general is one of the reasons behind many problems faced by logistics sector.
Ketahui dengan ada jalan tol ini itu akan mempercepat arus mobilisasi baik untuk tentunya untuk transportasi darat ya, sehingga produksi tanaman atau kebun yang ada di sana bisa cepat termobilisasi sampai ke kota, terutama ke Jakarta. Kedua, pertumbuhan ekonomi di sana akibatnya akan membuat orang tertarik untuk berinvestasi.
Syafril also reminded government to remain consistent with the commitment of accelerating infrastructure development in the country. More support on land acquisition, for example, is one of the most crucial factors to help highway development progressing better. As it has been known, government showed its commitment on better infrastructure development this year through bigger allocation for this post in the state budget. The total budget in 2015 revised state budget was 290.3 trillion rupiah, higher than 177.9 trillion rupiah last year. There was also a significant increase compared to 2013, where the budget was only 155.9 trillion, and also 2012, when it was only 145.5 trillion. Jakarta, Ayos Carlos and Olena Wibisana, MNC Business.
Back on Economic Buzz, this program can also be viewed through StarHub Asia Channel 121 and MNC International. Both channels can be viewed in Singapore. With me, Erwin Suryabrata. This is Mathieu Lefevre, Executive Director at New Cities Foundation, or NCF. Go log on to the homepage at newcitiesfoundation.org, and we are going to talk more about this. If I may rephrase my question, Mathieu, perhaps some of them just joined our talk show this evening. Specific challenges faced by Indonesia as a nation. Geographically speaking, it won't be very easy in terms of creating this kind of interconnectivity. And at the same time, we talked that the main support factor is to have this kind of strong interconnectivity, so everyone not going to go overflowing onto one spot in the nation.
Yeah, absolutely. I think one of the specific challenges and also opportunities that Indonesia faces in its urban development is its geography, of course, which is so unique for a country with, I think, 17,000 islands and cities that are far removed. I think air traffic and air hubs are going to develop a lot. Your report earlier talked about 30 new airports being built, etc. But also all the infrastructure investments that will be made in the future to really empower Indonesian cities to grow. Financing and urban financing is something that we look at the New Cities Foundation. We've just launched an initiative called Urban Finance Initiative, which looks at this challenge which is faced by all cities, which is how are we going to pay for all the infrastructure investments that we need? What financial mechanisms will we use? Where will we get the funds? How will risks be measured, etc.? And I think this really applies to Indonesian cities very well.
How costly can it be by the time we talk about realizing the ideal city concept? It must cost us a lot of fortune by the time we talk about the funding, the financing scheme and mechanism as well.
Sure. I think put together, this investment in the world cities will amount to the largest infrastructure investment in our history, in mankind's history. But it's an investment, it's not a cost. It's an investment in making our cities cleaner, more livable, more...
So it should be for the longer term purpose.
Exactly, yeah, yes, yes. Because otherwise you have cities that are congested, that have slums, etc. So these investments, empowered by technology, which is also something that's new on the scene, this smart city concept, these investments are really for our future.
At the same time, since we are on business, we talk about business as well, with the positive, what do you call this, positive purpose, positive aspect in asking you this question, can we generate something out of it by the time we talk about investing in the urban development?
Absolutely. I think it's a enormous opportunities for business, for example.
So not only benefiting the society, but also actually from the business aspect.
Oh, absolutely.
It will be very attractive.
Absolutely. And what's really interesting is also one of our goals in promoting this global event here in Jakarta about the future of cities is that cities and businesses learn from one another. If you think about the busway or the BRT here in Jakarta, that was imported from South America. If you think about the shared bike system, which is so common in many cities across Asia and the world, that was imported from France. Cities are copying, and businesses in cities are copying one another because they know that something that works in one city is very likely to work in another city. So it's an exciting time of opportunity.
Speaking of adopting the success story from other places, another town here in the world, can you mention one or two, three countries where we can actually look up, you know, like as the role model?
I think there's two things. There's one, every city is unique, and so you have to listen to your inhabitants and really understand what they want and what their expectations are. But of course, you have to look around, and looking around and listening to best case studies is what we're trying to do with the New Cities Summit in June. I think it's wiser probably to look at cities that have similar geographies so that they're by the sea. Mm. For example, Jakarta suffers from great problems with floods. Mm. So there are other case studies in the Netherlands and elsewhere where Jakarta can learn. Also, traffic congestion is not unique to Indonesian cities. Cities in China, right, in Thailand, and elsewhere, and in Brazil. I'm very struck, for example, when I walk around Jakarta at how much it looks like Sao Paulo in Brazil.
All right, so similar strategic approach can be implemented or can be applied by the time we are looking at the other countries, but it has similarity with Jakarta and Indonesia in general. Another session to discuss more about this. Make sure you are still with us on Economic Buzz. We are going to discuss more about New Cities Foundation with Mathieu Lefevre.
Stay tuned for more business insights on MNC Business.
Business world, based on current issues and real facts.
Investasi nampaknya menjadi salah satu tumpuan utama bagi tumbuhnya ekonomi.
Regardless of the kind of business you're in.
Untuk menurunkan Bank Indonesia rate sebesar 25 basis point.
Give you more insight before you act. Special report. Only on MNC Business. Talk show about current business affairs. Focuses on advocating many angles of local and international business interests.
Gaun untuk show tapi bertema siang seperti ini.
Pakai jilbab tapi maunya yang princess kayak gitu. Nah itu yang harus kita buat.
Presenting the most competent and trustworthy business people.
Apapun yang pelanggan inginkan yang akan kita siapkan.
This brief. Only on MNC Business.
Another business news for you. Business viewers, following the rising middle power in the country, the demand for property in middle upper level is reported to increase. Conversely, decreasing demand is seen in some areas with mining business dependency for living, such as in Kalimantan.
Continuous decrease of mining-based exportation, such as coal in global market, is reported to be impacting the performance of property sector in Indonesia this year. Even though the data showed that there is indeed an increased demand towards property, following the rapid increase of middle-income people in the country. However, the demand in middle-upper level is reported to be decreasing. Entrepreneur in property sector Sahat Pasaribu stated, based on the data, decreasing demand towards property occurred in some areas in the country with mining business for livelihood, such as in Kalimantan.
Ekspor kita kan masih rendah. Banyak orang-orang seperti di Kalimantan Timur, contoh saya amatin di Kalimantan Timur sekarang malah permintaan properti menurun. Penghasilan masyarakat menurun. Penghasilan dari banyak pengangguran loh kita sekarang. Dari sektor bidang sektor pertambangan banyak kita pengangguran.
The decreasing demand towards property is indeed has been predicted by some industry players in domestic. It is indicated that the decreasing demand is pretty much caused by some policy implemented by the government, such as policy on fuel price and electricity tariff increase. Business players of the industry stated that as the impact of the policy, it leads into higher cost production, that it is eventually burdening the society. Jakarta, Ayos Carlos and Olena Wibisana, MNC Business.
Finance Ministry will be focusing on property sector to optimize tax revenue this year. By far, there have been many property transactions that are not being monitored. So the ministry believes the tax on the property sector could help the government to achieve tax revenue target.
Ministry of Finance asks property industry players to get discipline in paying the tax and reporting property transaction to the authority. The ministry indicates that there are still a lot of business players in the sector which are not disciplined regarding this responsibility. As it has been known, property sector is reported to be growing quite significantly. It is even reported that apartment price has become quite high these days, and however, there is no significant contribution from the sector towards national tax revenue. Previously, government is setting tax revenue in 2015 to be 1,200 trillion rupiah. This will be quite a task for the government to achieve the target, as it was reported that tax revenue target in the previous years have never been achieved. In order to realize the target, government will be optimizing the potential existed, such as by applying value-added tax on highway, which currently is becoming quite an issue in the country, as there are pro and contra regarding the policy implementation. Jakarta, Rajo Patmo for MNC Business.
You are still with us on Economic Buzz. We still bring our discussion about understanding urban development challenges with New Cities Foundation, or NCF. Mathieu, early on we talked about how we can ask for the government support through their policies, because as the regulator, they're the one who can create an ideal policy that can support this kind of urban development, and we can tackle this kind of urban development challenges as well. We are also working close as our partner with Transformasi, Public Policy Transformation, the Center for Public Policy Transformation. Now, what kind of relationship NCF has established with Transformasi to support policy dialogue as well as capacity building program with Indonesian mayors, let's say, and also their key important strategic staff?
Well, what we're bringing to Jakarta in June, from 9 to 11 June, is the New City Summit, which is a really a global event. We've had it in Paris, in Sao Paulo, in Dallas, and now we're bringing it to Asia for the first time. It's a global discussion, 800 people from 50 countries, CEOs, entrepreneurs, startups, investors, mayors, even artists and philosophers. But we want to make it locally relevant. We want this to kick off a transformation of Indonesian cities. And to do that, we need great local partners here, and particularly in the public sector. And so Transformasi, we're very excited about working with them, because they are really working with local government officials, with mayors, on this transformation of Indonesia. And so the partnership seemed very natural to us. We bring a global discussion and best practices, and they will hopefully help implement it here to improve Indonesian cities, which is one of our goals.
So you see Transformasi as the best effective channel in terms of bridging you, the summit, as well as the Indonesian government.
Yes, absolutely. Yeah.
I see. Specific more about this summit, all the way come to Asia and to Jakarta, to Indonesia. Why Jakarta? It's a privilege for us, of course, but then this has also raised us a question, why would you choose Jakarta in the first place, in the first time in Asia, if I'm not mistaken?
Yes, yeah. Absolutely. Well, the event takes place in a different continent every year, and it moves around to learn about the case studies of a particular region and a particular city. And we were approached by the government of Jakarta to bring it here, and I have to admit that I had never been to Indonesia, and I didn't really know that much about Jakarta. And I came here, and I was really struck by this sense of optimism and this sense of opportunity that I was talking about, which is why we chose Jakarta, because it remains, I don't want to say mysterious, but it's not very well known what the great dynamism of this city outside Asia, perhaps. So we're very excited to be here, and I think for our Asian conversation on cities, it's a perfect place, because it embodies both the challenges, traffic, flooding, and others, but also the huge opportunity of Asian cities. And very much of the urban story takes place in Asia. So we're very excited to be in Asia and very, very excited to be partnering with the governor here to bring this event to Jakarta.
How excited can we be in terms of facing and welcoming this event in terms of creating perception or image about our beloved capital city Jakarta to this reputable international event called Summit of the NCF?
Well, I'm sure it will be great. I mean, we were really struck by the hospitality of people here, by their sense of opportunity, their desire to partner. So all of the entrepreneurs, CEOs, etc., who will come here for the first time, I think they'll have a really happy surprise and discover the great potential of Indonesia and of Jakarta.
How long the summit will last?
It will last 3 days, but really it will be a week because there are side events and other activities. And so we welcome, you know, the opportunity to collaborate with whoever wants to take part and join the discussion in some way.
All right. Another more detail about the summit will be brought to our viewers soon after this one. Mathieu. Economic Buzz will be back soon with more feed from Mathieu Lefevre, Executive Director at New Cities Foundations.
Leaving it.
Nyalakan semarak keceriaan bersama tayangan-tayangan unggulan Glowing North on MNC Channels. Teman bermain sekaligus tempat mengenal pengetahuan baru bagi anak-anak dalam Glowing on MNC Kids, Bear Friends, Fun Club, Tokyo Kid. Bersinarlah lewat gaya dan jadilah fashionista di Glowing on MNC Fashion. Fashion Star, Launch My Life, Celebrity Style Story. Nyalakan semarak keceriaan dalam Glowing March on MNC Entertainment. Bootcamp, asli kena jebak. Kuis apa ini, apa itu? Percantik dan hadirkan kenyamanan dalam hunian. Dalam Glowing on MNC Home and Living. Living SLM, Million Dollar Decorators, I Want a Garden. Rasakan sinar keceriaan bersama Glowing March on MNC Channels. Special Business Talk Show.
Melihat harga beras saat ini mungkin
Bulog itu sebelumnya Desember
Focuses
Januari.
Focuses on main economic issues. Presenting policymakers.
Ya, kita punya 1,4 juta ton cadangan di Bulog, kan? Nah, kalau kurang nanti kalau perlu kita import.
Government officials and experts.
Membeli beras langsung dari petani desa itu melalui BUMDes.
Economic view on MNC Business. Architecture, interior design, landscape design, furniture, ornament, color and pattern on MNC Home and Living.
Another business news for you. The government would revise the presidential regulation about Trans-Sumatra Highway Development acceleration immediately. Minister of Public Works and People's Housing explained that the state contractor company will be responsible for more tasks than it was given earlier.
Government would soon revise the Presidential Regulation No. 100 Year 2014 about Trans-Sumatra Highway Development Acceleration. After the regulation is being revised, the state company in charge for the development, PT Hutama Karya, would be getting more details on the company's task related to the project. Minister of Public Works and People's Housing Basuki Hadi Mulyono stated that with the revision, state contractor company PT Hutama Karya, which is appointed to be responsible in some part of the development, would be getting more tasks than the company previously given. As it has been reported before, PT Hutama Karya is initially given responsibility to do 4 lanes of the highway. However, after the regulation being revised, the company would have to do the construction of 23 lanes of the highway.
Revisi perpresnya sekarang lagi dikerjakan oleh
Kementerian BUMN, karena hanya sedikit, ada sedikit multi tafsir di sana, di Perpres 100. Di sana sebutkan bahwa penugasan pada Hutama Karya di empat ruas itu. Nah, ini mau direvisi, sedangkan ada klausul lain bahwa ruas-ruas lainnya akan ditentukan oleh Menteri.
It is plain that Hutama Karya would be establishing subsidiary company. This is so the company would be able to accelerate the development of Trans Sumatra Highway to support connectivity in Indonesia. Meanwhile, looking at the Presidential Regulation No. 100 Year 2014, Hutama Karya is in charge for the development of Medan Binjai Lane of 16 km, Palembang Indralaya Lane of 22 km, Bakaheni Terbanggi of 138 km, and Pekanbaru Dumai of 135 km. Jakarta, Ayos Carlos, MNC Business.
You're watching Economy Buzz with Mathieu Lefevre, Executive Director at New Cities Foundation, or NCF, to share his view of the topic that we bring up in this talk show. NCF, New Cities Foundation, why you should come to Indonesia as well? How do you see from Indonesia representing NCF as the Executive Director?
Well, I think Indonesia is full of promise and surprises, as I was saying. And every time I come here, I just want one thing is to take 2 months off and to go travel in some of the
islands. There is always something new.
There is always something new, apparently. Yeah, absolutely. But it really inspired us to devise the topics for the summit in June, and we were really inspired by the experience of this city.
What are actually the main area of working at NCF, and what things will you cover here in Indonesia?
Well, I think for the New Cities Summit in June here in Jakarta, we will cover some of the issues that all cities ask themselves. So we're going to talk about housing and affordable housing, which is a very, very important question for people here, but also in Paris, in New York, in Tokyo, in Beijing. We're going to talk about traffic, of course. Indonesia, Jakarta, has the worst traffic in the world now, officially. Yeah. So of course we're going to talk about
that. Notoriously known for that.
Notoriously known, and I've experienced it myself today many times.
On the way here, right away.
On the way here, absolutely. Yeah. We're going to talk about something that I think has enormous potential, which is technology. People talk about smart cities, etc. Technology really has transformational potential. How do you use technology? And in Asia, people use technology a lot. The penetration of social media, for example, is extremely high. In Jakarta is one of the biggest cities in the world. So we're going to talk about how technology can help us seize the urban moment. And seizing the urban moment is our overall theme. But we're going to talk about design, architecture. We're going to talk about the role of culture, you know, and cultural institution and tourism in creating a city's identity. So we're going to talk about all of that. There will be 90 speakers, lots of different sessions.
90. That's a lot of speakers.
From all over the world. And we're very excited because some very prominent CEOs and speakers, including Mohamed Yunus, the Nobel Peace Prize winner, will come to announce a major initiative at our summit. So it's going to be a very rich conversation.
Okay, speaking about the previous summit, how was it going, the last summit, let's say? Which town as the host, and then what kind of result has been discussed there during the previous last summit before Jakarta?
Right. Well, our last summit was in Dallas, Texas, which is a city that is reinventing itself. So the theme last year was reimagining cities. And I'm really proud and touched that our summit kicked off a conversation for Dallas. They're still talking about the issues, and they've implemented programs as a result of our summit. The summit is a great spark of inspiration, but then it's for local partners and local companies and mayors, etc., to take that energy and transform it into action. Talking is great, and it's very important, and imagining and dreaming up your city is essential, but it's all about action.
Yeah. Put it into practice, really walk the talk, right? We use the last session to sum up and conclude our discussion for this evening.
Mark. Great.
Make sure you are still with us. We still have one more session on eBus discussing about understanding urban development challenges with New Cities Foundation, or NCF. You can go visit the homepage at newcitiesfoundation.org.
Stay tuned for more business insights on MNC Business.
Start your day with more quality and knowledge. Get inspiration from the newest information.
Berpotensi menuju ke level 13 ribuan.
From economy,
krisis beras diprediksi akan terjadi.
Business,
Bank Sentral Amerika Serikat itu akan menaikkan suku bunganya.
And general news.
Harus sinergi.
So, here's your inspiring breakfast. Our breakfast. Only on MNC Business. Memperingati ulang tahun MNC News yang ke-9. Berpartisipasilah dalam Citizen Journalism Contest. Rekam peristiwa penting, unik, dan menarik. Upload video yang telah dikemas secara menarik ke YouTube. Lalu share link YouTube Anda ke akun Twitter @MNC News Channel. Tersedia hadiah menarik bagi para pemenang. Segera, jadilah bagian dari dunia informasi. Video terpilih akan kami tayangkan di MNC News Channel 84 Indovision. Our Breakfast.
We have reached our last session discussing about understanding urban development challenges with New Cities Foundation, NCF. We're going to have another view from Mathieu Lefevre, Executive Director at New Cities Foundation, to conclude his view toward our topic. Well, in short, we keep discussing about the government support and then how business actually can create a much conducive and friendlier urban cities and also spatial area. But it's rarely been discussed also in the media when we talk about the community awareness. All of those will mean nothing if you don't have this kind of a growing community awareness. How NCF, through your projects and programs, in the same time can encourage this kind of community awareness?
Right, absolutely. I'm so glad you asked that question, because too often people talk about government and the private sector, etc., but it leaves out a third part, a third leg of the stool, which is the people. Mm-hmm. And I think the nature of organization and power has changed a lot. People have a lot more power than they used to, for example, because they have a tool in their pocket, many of them, called a smartphone, or even a not smartphone, where they can express their views. We talked about social media earlier, where the penetration in Asia and in Jakarta is enormous. And so there's a real need and an opportunity for people to create a movement for this green city that we've been talking about. And that can be very powerful.
What are the key messages would like to be brought up to our society through the summit for this 2015, the coming June in Jakarta?
Well, I think the main message that we will bring is to focus on cities. If you want to drive progress and drive change on the economy, on job creation, on environmental issues, on social issues, focus on cities. Cities are where change happens. That's the main message. And then we want to bring everybody in, the companies, the public sector, the people, nonprofits, etc., into the mix, so that together we can have that conversation to make cities better.
All right, Mathieu, I mustn't hold you for any longer. Mathieu Lefevre, you are the Executive Director at New Cities Foundation. Merci beaucoup. Again, thank you so much.
Thank you.
Welcome
very
back to Jakarta.
Much.
We are expecting you to back again to Jakarta.
Never with
we want
great
to come
pleasure.
To Indonesia. And again, merci beaucoup. Au revoir.
Thank you. Au revoir. Merci.
That's wrap up our talk show for this time. Hope to have you soon in the next Economic Buzz with other issues to bring up in the discussion. I'm Erwin Suryabrata, wishing you best luck in doing your business today. Let's talk about your business in eBus, only on MNC Business. Don't forget, we are the first business channel in Indonesia. Watch our live streaming through www.sindonews.com. Thank you.
All right.
Make it
Thank
quicker.
You.